Hello friends, I am Saket. I welcome you all to our webinar related to Scrum roles. Today we will talk about Scrum roles, and Scrum roles are becoming important for especially for PMI ACT exam, because invariably I am getting a feedback that people are getting 3 to 4 questions at least on Scrum roles. And Scrum overall is contributing a good amount of question to exam. So let us see what all this a Scrum role is all about. So in Scrum, we have three roles: product owner, Scrum master, and development team. So Scrum framework talks about only these three roles, and these are the three roles which are committed to a Scrum project. Rest of the roles, rest of the stakeholders, sponsors are involved. These are the three roles or who are working for the delivery or the success of the project. And everything starts from Scrum Master. Now, Scrum Master is a coach, and the Albert Einstein quote is very suitable for the Scrum Master. I never teach my students. I only attempt and provide them a condition where they can learn. So a Scrum Master has a responsibility to provide an environment where team can deliver. Now, before we get into the role of a Scrum Master, we should also understand the stages of Scrum team. And because why it is important? The Scrum Master role, the Scrum Master attitude or Scrum Master style of managing team will change as per the team stage. So team passes through three stages: su, ha, ri. So su, these are the Japanese terminologies. So su is a stage where the team or the student just have to follow the rule, because they are very new to the process. They don't understand the details of or the principle and values behind those practices. So at the su stage, team must follow the practices as given, prescribed by Scrum. And by practicing those practices, they get to understand the principles, the ideas, the goal behind those practices. So once they master the practice, they reaches the stage called ha. At a ha stage, team is self-organizing. Team has already understood the values and principle behind all the Scrum practices. At this particular stage, team may start taking deviations. Team may start breaking the existing Scrum rules in order to achieve the better output. But they follow the practice, if they follow the value and principle. So at the place of having a daily Scrum meeting, say daily Scrum meeting, the time box prescribed is 15 minutes, they may start having a daily Scrum meeting of 10 minutes or 5 minutes or maybe 20 minutes, because they understand what is the goal of daily Scrum meeting. And once they understood, they imbibe their coordination and collaboration goal, then they modify the rule as to give them maximum benefit. That's a half stage. And once they passes that half stage, they become master of the values and principle of Agile. They may create their own rule. At the place of daily Scrum, they may have something else which gives the collaboration and coordination objective to the team. And that is called restage, where team started making their own rules. So a new team is a shoe team, where the Scrum Master needs to play a role of a teacher. When team is at the initial stage, when the team is just new to the Scrum, the Scrum Master has to become a teacher and teach the team the Scrum rules. Once team reaches at the half stage, the Scrum Master has to play the role of a coach, where he needs to create an environment, where he needs to create a supportive environment where team can grow and team can perform their duties. When team is at a restage, the Scrum Master has to work as an advisor. He only interferes when asked. He only advises the team, but team takes the final decision. Now, for exam point of view, when you get a situation and it is expected from you to identify what is the role of a Scrum Master, until if the situation or the question is giving you an idea of a team stage, then you should select the option as per teacher, coaching or advisor role. But if the question is silent about the background of the Scrum team, by default you should assume that team is at a half stage, where they are already where they have already understood the Scrum values and principle, and they are taking some deviations, but they are self-organized and they are self-managed. So Scrum Master, the first role of Scrum Master is he has to ensure that Scrum is getting implemented. So because he's a Scrum Master, so from name itself, his role comes into the place where he's responsible for implementation of Scrum values and principle in a team. He has a responsibility of introducing Scrum roles, Scrum ceremonies, Scrum practices to the team. He explains the role to a team member, role to a product owner, and the objective of each Scrum ceremony, be it daily Scrum meeting, be it retrospective meeting. And he needs to ensure that the team is adhering to Scrum values. So the first responsibility of Scrum Master revolve around Scrum. He need to ensure that everybody is playing the role as per the Scrum. He need to ensure that the product owner is following the goal and objective of Scrum ceremonies. Means if the sprint review is for the product feedback, we should not be discussing the points which are related to process feedback. The process feedback should be discussed in retrospective meeting. So he has to ensure that Scrum values, Scrum principles are implemented in a project, in a team. He needs to ensure that Scrum ceremonies are performed as per their goals. Now, once Scrum is implemented, he needs to ensure that team is productive. Now, Scrum Master is not responsible for delivering the results to the business. He is responsible for creating a productive team which delivers results to the business. So he has to play a facilitator role and a coach role which facilitates, creates an environment which makes team productive and team starts delivering. He acts as a moderator for various ceremonies, and he also acts as a facilitator for all these ceremonies. Now, he also has a responsibility of removing hurdles or any external interferences which coming in the way of a team member, which in the form of impediments. So a team, whenever team faces an impediment, Scrum Master has a role to play to remove these hurdles so team can perform and give a business output to the product owner as well as to the organization. Scrum Master also needs to work to improve engineering practices and tools. Now, in Agile, we talk about extrinsic quality as well as intrinsic quality. So Scrum Master has a role to play that he ensures the intrinsic quality, the inside, the quality which is not visible from outside, but which is inside the product, the way the code has been designed, the way the system has been developed, it should be adaptable. So if your product is intrinsically quality, if your product's intrinsic quality is good, it is more adaptable for the future needs. So Scrum Master has to ensure that team is following good engineering practices and producing the product which is adaptable for future need. Scrum Master plays a role to remove barrier between development and product owner. Now, sometimes we feel that Scrum Master is a middleman between product owner and developer. It is not like that. Scrum Master should ensure that developer and product owner should feel comfortable talking to each other related to product prioritization or related to any clarification which team may be needing. He should not become a middleman or a communication channel between product owner and team. Now, if product owner is not following his role, if product owner is not clear about a prioritizing feature, Scrum Master also has a role to play where he Sorry for an interruption. I thought I got disconnected. So now see, he teaches the product owner how to maximize the return on investment. He also has a role to play where he improves the creativity and empowerment in team. Now, he has a role to play in shielding the team from external interferences. Now, the another important role, he need to keep information about team's progress up to date and visible to all parties. So as I spoke initially, that Scrum Master, the Agile has, the Scrum process has three legs: transparency, inspection, and adaption. So Scrum Master has a role to play in maintaining transparency. He needs to keep information related to team work progress visible to all the parties. Now, if we summarize, now there were various names used for describing the Scrum Master role. One was bulldozer, shepherd, servant leader, guardian of quality and performance. And these names, this definition helps us in visualizing the role of a Scrum Master. So Scrum Master is a bulldozer. So he helps a team in bulldozing the impediments which come in their way so the team can perform. He is a shepherd. So when team stray from the agile practices, when team stray from the Scrum practices, he has a responsibility to bring them back. So he has a role to play as a shepherd where he bring back his team to the Scrum and engineering practices. He's a servant leader. So he leads the team by serving them rather than directing and controlling and giving them the direction of what to do and what not to do. He has a role to play where he serves the team and manage the team, motivate the team by way of serving them. He's a guardian of quality and performance. And we spoke about extrinsic and intrinsic quality. So Scrum Master has a role to play where he performs that not only what team is producing, but also focuses on how they are producing. So it also focuses on the processes, the assurance, the compliances the team should follow while producing an engineering output. So a few do's and don'ts. So Scrum Master has to guide and facilitate rather than directing or driving. He has to keep everybody's focus on delivering business value rather than just sticking to the deadlines. Because he has to focus on business value than just focusing on a build dates or iteration dates or release dates. Now he has to focus on overall team performance. He has to create a high performance team rather than focusing on a specific outcome. His goal is to create a high performance team rather than just achieving a short term goals. Now he should not be involving in creating day-to-day tasks and allocating day-to-day tasks to their team members. He has to coach and create the high performance team so the team itself manages their work. Because in Scrum, team is the manager. Scrum Master is not the manager of the team. So he is just a coach who provides an environment, who creates the self-managing team. And he has to promote the skills and growth of every team member so the team member can represent, can give a demo during the sprint review meeting. He should not become only voice of the team. It's not like that whenever somebody or a customer or a stakeholder or a product owner needs an information about the progress or about a product, he should not be the only one who answers it. Team should handle those queries. Team should present the day-to-day activities or the outcome of iteration to the stakeholders rather than Scrum Master playing the front role always. So Scrum Master protects and shields the team from any negative influence and keep it focused to the focus to attain sprint objective. So before I move to a product owner, I check the question box and will try to answer as many. Now, Dheeraj, I could not get your complete question. Please type it the complete. Now, did Scrum Master has to get time to organize a Scrum? I did not get the question. Please type it the complete one. So I will try to answer it. Any question on Scrum Master? Anybody who has a question, please write it in your question box. Just I am looking at the question box as okay, so there was one question that can I reiterate the intrinsic and extrinsic quality? Yes, intrinsic and extrinsic quality are a quality dimension from the perspective of view. The extrinsic quality is a quality which is visible from outside. So customer only sees the extrinsic quality. So if you, for example, buy a car, so the performance, the output, the outlook, the car which is visible to you is its extrinsic quality. Now intrinsically it may have an engine, it may have a wirings, and how easy to change those connections, how easy to replace those things, how cleanly, how structurally the internals has been made, that represents the intrinsic quality. Now while we follow Agile, intrinsic quality becomes important, because in Agile we don't visualize, or we don't target to visualize the complete scope upfront. So we target to develop a adaptive product. So the product can only be adaptive when it is good in intrinsic quality, because else the adaption or the changes in the product will take more time and it will produce a poor quality product. Now the other question is, did Scrum Master or Scrum Owner take extra time from delivery timelines? Will this time will be part of deliverables? Now is this if I understand that it is something to do with the Slack? Yeah. Now this is a project management problem. So irrespective of methodology you follow, be it Scrum, be it Agile, be it Waterfall, the project management works with the judgment. The project management works with the takes into account the uncertainty in estimates. So if you have an uncertain estimate, you may take a slack while committing your external dates. Now committing the release dates or committing the composition of the release to the external stakeholders is not the Scrum Master's job. Now in Agile, the Scrum Master's job is, as far as Scrum principle is concerned, is limited to coach and guide the team member. After that, team is responsible for delivering it, and a product owner is responsible for the product owner is responsible for identifying the composition of release. So it's a project management thing they may take. Now another question, Scrum Master is involved in the performance evaluation of the team. Does this make Scrum Master a people manager? Now this is a case by case. A few company follows, say in few company people report to the product owner, in few company people report to the Scrum Master. As far as Scrum framework is concerned, it has nothing to, like Scrum framework is silent on performance appraisal. So if in an organization structure the people are reporting to Scrum Master, then he may do a performance appraisal. Now a few author or few Scrum writers are very against it. They believe that Scrum, the people should never report to a Scrum Master, but a few of them are okay with it. But as far as Scrum framework is concerned, Scrum framework is silent on it. So is Scrum Master is a specific person, says a project manager. Now sometime like I feel that we should have a special session where we talk about differences between Scrum Master and product project manager, because in various session we get this question. Now what I try to reiterate here is that a project manager plays various roles. Like he commits the date, he prepares the budget, he communicates with the stakeholders and identify the requirement, he creates the high level scope. Now if you see our quiz, all the questions which I have posted in the quiz were actually coming from PMP role guideline book, which is published by PMP, that as a PMP certified person, he should be playing all these roles. So the 15 question quiz which I posted, all the roles, all the tasks were coming from a project manager's role profile. Now in Agile, they are played by different individuals. Like in Agile, the team becomes their own manager. The product owner becomes responsible for budget, etc., budget timelines. And Scrum Master just is focusing on coaching and mentoring and creating a high performance team. So if you look in depth, that 15 question quiz which I have posted before this webinar, all those tasks were coming from PMP role book, like the tasks which are expected to be performed by a PMP certified person. Okay, now a final question before we move to now in Agile, at what stage we estimate the budget? It is estimated at a release level. So in Scrum, now if the problem is that most of the Scrum teams are not following release planning because they are working on subsequent release. So if you have a situation where you are developing a first time the product and you are planning the first release of it, you would be preparing the budget during your iteration 0 or before you start your iteration 1 in the form of release planning. So release plan is a basic input for your budget, and that is where the earned value, like budget at completion or budget baselines, get prepared. So once you are done with the release planning, you can baseline your budget, or you can estimate your budget and timelines. Okay, one more. Is a Scrum Master from development team or from QA team? Now these are the roles which Scrum Master has to play. Now he could be from anywhere. Now in practice, I have seen Scrum Masters coming from development as well as from testing. Like I have seen test managers becoming a Scrum Master, and I have seen development leads or a project managers becoming a Scrum Master. So he has to play a role of coaching, mentoring, and he should have a good system thinking. He should have a good people skills, good emotional intelligence, and once it has, it depends upon the organization. So let us move. You can keep writing your questions. So I will take them once we are done with a product owner. So product owner. Now a product owner is a mouthpiece of stakeholder and customer. He represents the customer. He represents the business to the team. He is a business representative for development team. Whatever he speak is driven by the business. He is responsible for generating profit out of development work. He is responsible for maximizing the profit from team's work, because he is the one who is representing business to the team. He is responsible for visualizing the complete concept, visualizing the final outcome, and deciding what all components or what forms the minimum marketable feature of the product. And on the basis of those features, he is the one who decides the release date. Now what happens during a release planning meeting? Product owner comes with the prioritized product backlog, where he has an inventory of prioritized features, and the team declares their capacity. So in a release planning meeting, the balancing has to happen between the capacity and the priorities. Now product owner takes the call related to the priority, and we as a framework, we assume the capacity is fixed. Nothing can be done on for the capacity. So on the basis of capacity, or if you talk technical term, a velocity of the team, the product owner decides what would be the release date. Now how that release date get decided? On the basis of his condition of satisfaction, like what are the minimum features he wants to see in the product. But he's the one who takes the call related to the release date and the composition of the release. Now he has a complete control on a product backlog, and he He is the one who grooms the product backlog. He is the one who prioritizes it. He is the one who slice it or make it a small slice of those work. Now he has a right to accept or reject the team's work. Like he gives a requirement to the team and he verifies the running product or the final outcome, and he has a right to accept or reject the work once the team is done with the development. It's a good acronym, again, which can represent the expectation from product owner. It's a CRACK: committed, responsible, authorized, collaborative, knowledgeable. So he is committed to the work. He is engaged with the team. He is not like who is a part-time member of a team. He is engaged and he is responsible for the outcome. He is the one who is giving the work. Team is just converting in his priorities into a running software. And he is authorized by the sponsor. He is authorized by the people who are paying the bill to take decisions related to the product development. And he also know for which all decisions he need to consult with others. But for team, he is the one who gives them the final guideline. He is collaborative, so he should be collaborative while interacting with team as well as Scrum Master. And he should be knowledgeable about business. His main focus, his main skill is business knowledge, domain knowledge. He works as a living requirement document. He knows what should be implemented. He is the best person to know or discuss about business. So do and don'ts of product owner. He has to focus on what rather than how. Like he should not be talking about how the development should be done, how the team should organize their work. He should focus on what are the business priority. He can challenge the team rather than bullying them. He should also demonstrate the commitment towards building a high performance team. So when he says a commitment towards high performance team, means he should focus on long-term goals rather than just focusing on this particular iteration, focusing on forcing the team member to do overtime, etc. He should focus on sustainable development. He should focus on long-term outcomes and building a high performance team. He practices business value driven thinking rather than sticking to the original scope. And if he is sticking to the original scope, Scrum Master must teach him that in Agile, he should focus on business value driven thinking. Now, Scrum Master has a role to play to explain role to the individuals, whoever is forgetting about it. So if team is straying, he has to teach them. If product owner is straying from his role, Scrum Master has a role to play to explain his role to him back. And he has to protect team from outside noise. Now, Scrum Master works as a filter. The stakeholders are giving requirement to him. Rather than making team confused or worried about the expected future changes, he should work as a filter for the team and keep the team isolated from the external noise and give them a consistent filtered view for their future development. So product owner is the real motive behind the project development. He is the one who is giving you the work. He is the one who is giving you the money. He is the one who is giving the scope. He is the one who is giving you the time. So product owner is a primary motive, a real motive behind the project development. Okay, I take questions. So any question on product owner before we move to the team? Now, how is a product owner different from the sponsor? So you can think of sponsor has given a product owner authority to work on his behalf. Now, sponsor is not involved in day-to-day activity. He is a sponsor guy who is involved in a day-to-day activity. So he is an authorized person from the sponsor to spend money to deploy a team member for a project. So he's a representative of a sponsor. So that is what the difference between product owner and sponsor. Sponsor is the one who is like giving an approval or giving an authority to a product owner to take this project forward. But the sponsor is not involved in day-to-day activities, but product owner is involved day in, day out. He's the requirement guy for the project. Any other query? Now, the question is how filtering is done at Scrum Master level. Can you be more elaborative? What do you mean by filtering? Are you asking that how filtering or a product feature prioritization are done at a product owner level? If that is the question, then the product owner has to use their own metrics. There is a good amount of model which exists to help a product owner to do a value-based prioritization. So he can do a prioritization on the basis of desirability. He can also do a prioritization on the basis of financial value of the feature. So if the product owner is getting, usually product owner gets a multiple request, stakeholders give him a big list of requirement for the development. Now a product owner put a model in place, identify the value those features generate for the business, and on the basis of the values, he identify the priority for the team. Now, value is the first factor. Beyond value, he may also consider other dimensions like risk, like learning, or the cost of development. So even if you find that this particular feature is very good, but if you get an estimate for that feature which is too high, you may identify that it does not worth it. So there are four factors which plays a role in prioritizing or filtering the requirement, which are value, the value which we get out of that feature, the cost of developing that feature, the risk, like what all risk we can mitigate by including that feature or taking it upfront, and what type of learning we can do. Like if you want to, the fourth dimension could be the learning. If you want to do a future, like you may have a future release which would be focusing on social media. So you may want to include some features of the social media in this particular release. So you get an opportunity to learn the customer behavior. So there could be a complex combination of various factors, and these are the few factors which are prominently or used by the product owners. Okay, any other question related to product owner or Scrum Master's role? Okay, so let's move to the team. Can PO get sponsor on his idea from outside? Now, see, when we, in a Scrum, when we talk about a product owner, he is the one who is representing customer to the team. Now, if you are visualizing a service organization, a product owner represents the customer rather than a product owner becomes a part of the developing company. Now, if you visualize the product organization, a product owner is supported and authorized by the sponsor as well as the product roadmap team. Now, a product owner is the one who has money in hand and work in other hand. So he has work, he has a scope in hand, and he has a money to spend, and he has a target to provide return on that spending to the organization. So he is the one who has to manage the investment and returns. So if he can generate good ROI, he can take work from anywhere. So the profit responsibility or identifying the features which generate maximum value to the business is with product owner. Okay, so we move to the final role, a development team. Relatively less complicated and less confusing role. So now, I think now I am back and there was some glitch as usual. So it is now I think you should be able to hear me. I said na, there is a probability of getting a small glitch and which I usually get for a while. Okay, now we are back. So let me. So the development team, responsible for, now in general the role of development team is simple to visualize. Now why? Because they still have to develop the work. Now unlike the traditional development team, this development team is also responsible for managing their own work, and that is the primary difference we should keep in mind while dealing exam or while thinking about Agile. It is the development team is responsible for quality estimation and delivery. Now they are the one who estimates their work. They are the one who is responsible for ensuring quality of their work, and they are the one who are responsible for delivery of their work. Now they are self-managed. So the traditional manager role, team manager role is played by the development team because they are their own manager. Now they are responsible for converting a product backlog into a shippable product. They are responsible for managing their day-to-day tasks because they are the manager. So that is the difference which we should keep in mind. The development team is self-managed team and they are their own manager. They also make their rules of living together. Now the ground rules are prepared by the development team, and the enforcement of the ground rules is also a responsibility of development team because they are their manager. They are responsible for creating a sprint backlog and they are the one who prepares the definition of done. Now sometimes we feel that what happens if the team is not self-managed, team is not making the ground rules, team is not managing their day-to-day task, then who should take care of it? How to manage those kind of situation? Yeah, you may get these kind of situations, especially when you are at the teaching stage of your project. Now, at that particular time, Scrum Master has a responsibility to create a self-managing team. Now, as a Scrum Master, the Scrum Master should not be solving the short-term solution. He may take a short-term step by giving some direction to the team, but he should focus on solving the long-term problem. He has to create a self-organizing team. He has to ensure that team starts making their own task list and starts doing it. Rather than a Scrum Master starts creating a task list for the team, Scrum Master has a responsibility to generate a motivation, generate the required amount of awareness in a team, so they start making their own task list and starts working on it. Now there is a rule for a team size. It's a 7 ± 2, and it is self-dependent, which is means they are self-organized, self-managed, and they are cross-functional. So the team may have a developer, testers, UI designer, business analyst. They all form. They all are part of our team, and they interact with the customer, end users, PO. Stakeholders, they are fully authorized to interact with them. The development team is the one who who gives a product demo during the sprint review meeting or iteration review meeting. So if you visualize a cricket match, the team is the one which is winning and losing, not the coach. So similarly, the development team is responsible for winning the match, not the scrum master. So they have to play, they have to deliver, and the product owner gives them the priority. So product owner provides them a priority, provides them a goal, and the team, self-managed team, has to find out the ways of delivering those goals to the business. So the planning thing, like team, the planning activity is also done by the team. Now, traditionally, the task breakdown, the task estimations, all these responsibility falls under project manager. But the sprint planning, the output of sprint planning, which is a sprint backlog, is prepared by development team. The release planning is primarily because it is focusing on top level features is done by product owner. But during the release planning also, the estimation, the capacity declaration, means which is velocity as well as the size of the features or user stories, is derived or identified by the development team. So they are the ones who are responsible for planning, managing, and quality. So this ends the presentation related to these three roles. So in Agile, we have a three roles, or in a Scrum, we have a three roles: a product owner, Scrum Master, and development team. Product owner represents the business to the team. Whenever you get a customer, like he is the one who represents customer to the team. Scrum Master is a servant leader, bulldozer, shepherd, guardian of quality. He ensures that things remain and consistent, aligned with the Scrum rules, Scrum guidelines. Everybody performs as per the Scrum framework. And development team is a self-managed team responsible for planning their own work, managing their own work, and delivering the quality output to the business. Before we get into some of the quiz questions, let us take questions on team. Okay, so now first question is, I am speaking about 15 questions, where it is? Okay, most of you are coming through our LinkedIn group. So I shared the quiz of Scrum roles like yesterday, and that quiz was having all these 15 questions. So if you go to our PMI ACP certification made easy LinkedIn group, you will find the quiz. Else you can contact me, I can share the link. And you can also go to our slide share and download the quiz as well as the answers. Second question. Now the question is that so the development team alone can define the ground rules and definition of done. So they do it with the product owner and Scrum Master. Now, see the definition. Let us take this question in two segments. One is with the ground rules, and second is a definition of done. Now, see the Scrum Master has a responsibility to ensure that team identifies the right amount of ground rules which are necessary for them to function. Now, this role he has to perform indirectly. Means like now Scrum Master has to ensure that all necessary ground rules are identified by the team, and they make their own rules. So it is like Scrum Master gives them a required trigger. And if they are missing some triggers, so he tries to use an opportunity or show the consequences of not having those ground rules. So team identify them as a concern area during the retrospective meeting and make the ground rule for them. So indirectly, Scrum Master is responsible, but as a direct responsibility, team is the one who identifies their own rules, and team is the one who enforces that rule has been implemented. Yeah, so from PMI ACP point of view, ground rules are identified by team, because we assume a team at a hard stage. Until unless it is specified, it is at hard stage. So if you get a situation where team is very new and it is a shoe stage, then the Scrum Master may play a role to define the ground rules. So by default, ground rules are identified by team. Now, definition of done. Definition of done is a technical checklist of marking the feature are complete or not complete, or a story complete or not complete. It is not the acceptance criteria of that particular story. Now, the customer is, or customer or product owner is responsible or authorized to identify the acceptance criteria for a story. Now, definition of done is different from the acceptance criteria. So, say approval of product owner can be a step in definition of done. So, a team, since definition of done has many other technical details like the code should be checked in, the integration script should be performed, you may be using some automation code review system, so FXCOP, etc., those need to be executed, so we identify the non-compliance of coding standard, etc., etc. So those kind of steps are usually team identifiable step, and that is why the team has to define the definition of done. Now everybody should have a common understanding of the definition of done, which is a participative decision making, and which is like everybody understand what is the done means. But the team has a responsibility of defining what is done, and inside that done, most probably team all the team has a point where they take acceptance from product owner before they mark any story done. Does this answer? Okay. Now there was another question, like another suggestion, which is not directly to this. Like lot of time we share quiz, etc., over LinkedIn, and many of you are not accessing LinkedIn, so you miss all those things. So it's better to have a email platform or group where I can share all this information. So we are already working on it. Most probably within 5 or 10 days, our mailing list will become active, and once that is done, we will start sharing information over the mailing list as well. So now, let us take three questions where I found a good amount of confusions, and these three questions are coming from our 15 question quiz which we played in last 2 days. This was a question number 6. Who is responsible for analyzing the project performance and identifying the corrective and preventive action? The answer is team. Now, why? See, they are self-managed. They don't need a manager. And this is a manager's responsibility. Manager does it. Like manager has a responsibility of managing the work of their team. So in Agile, in Scrum, we have a self-managed team. So the team has a responsibility of analyzing, identifying the corrective and preventive actions, and where they and in which ceremony they do this in a project retrospective, sprint retrospective, release retrospective. So all retrospective meetings are meant for identifying corrective and preventive actions and reflecting on how they are working during the sprint. Now, second, who is responsible for enforcing the ground rule? Sorry. Who is responsible for enforcing the ground rules? So it's again team. Now, team is the one, because they are the manager. They create the rule. They are the one who is responsible for enforcing it. Now, do remember this particular point. For example, you may get a situation where the daily stand-up is happening, and two people start talking with each other, where you had a ground rule that when one person is speaking, other should just focus on him. And now the question may ask, who should intervene? So the first responsibility of handling this situation falls with the team itself. Now, if team is forgetting their role, straying from their Scrum roles, then Scrum Master has to come and explain that this is your role, please manage it and don't do this. So until unless the team, you get a clue that team is not aware about their Scrum roles, it is a team responsibility to enforce the ground rule, be it a daily Scrum meeting, be it any ceremony of Scrum. And this is something which you most probably get in your exam. So who is responsible for to keep information radiator updated? Now here, as many of you marked team. Now the Scrum Master is primarily responsible for keeping visibility transparency. So he has a first responsibility of ensuring that whatever team is doing is transparent to the external world, to everybody. So he is the one who is responsible for keeping the information radiator updated. Now there is a daily task board or a task board. Now task board is updated, managed by the team, because task board work as a management tool for the team. It is like a operation tool which they have in hand, by which they self-assign their work or by which they monitor their work. So a task board is managed and maintained by the team member. Scrum Master just has to ensure the task board is updated. But in general, if we talk about the responsibility of keeping the information radiator updated, Scrum Master is the first person to ensure that all the information radiators are updated. Now, few things about me. I think most of you know me. So I am Saket, and we do PMP, PMI, ACP, Agile and Scrum training. We do provide online PMI, ACP training, and these are my contact information. If you want to get in touch with me over mail, LinkedIn, phone, so here you can reach me. And now it's time to take the final set of the questions. Let us see what we have. Okay, so now I think product owner can do this. Now I am not getting the context when you written that what product owner can do it. So it would be do good if you can write the question. So if you have any question, please type it. I'm here to answer, and we are on time, and I think our process is quite stable now. We can predict the release end date. Now, yes, we have a question of 15 questions on LinkedIn. Yes, if you go to a LinkedIn, you will get it. And if you don't get it, then you just let me know. I will just share it. Or you can just visit the slideshare.com/SaketTG. You can get it. Now, another question. Could the PO take part in estimation, that is planning poker? In a planning poker, the PO has a role to play in explaining the requirement, not in estimating the number. So in a planning poker, PO has a role to play where he explains the details of the requirement. He also resolves when the people are estimating the story differently by making a different assumption. So PO has a role to play in clarifying the assumptions, in clarifying the requirement, but he has no role to play in giving a number or giving a size to a story. So PO explains the requirement, clarifies it whenever there is a different set of assumptions coming in the forum, but he has no role to play in giving the number for a user story. So giving a number is only with the team. So team is the responsible or authorized to give a number to a story. But if PO feels that they are not getting what is required, if he feels that they are estimating it too big, he can explain the requirement. So he has a role to play in clarifying the requirement to the team member, not giving a number to it. Now, how overall estimate is derived and communicated to the customer? Now, if you have a vendor customer, so the question is how overall estimate is derived and communicated to the customer. So if you have a vendor customer relationship, in that particular case, the release planning is an activity which helps you in identifying the overall estimate, and that estimate becomes a part of communicating to the customer. Now, irrespective of agile, non-agile, scrum or traditional project, estimations done at the initial stage will have good amount of error. So whenever there is a cone of uncertainty, whenever you are doing estimation at the very beginning of the project, it may have a variance of plus minus 50%. So with Agile also, we take a top-down approach. While doing a release level estimation, we do a story point based estimation, and you do get some amount of error, say 20 to 30% error may possible depending upon the type of project you are dealing in. If you are well aware about the technology and details of the requirement, your estimation accuracy would be higher. If you are not, your estimation accuracy would be poor. So at a release level, you calculate the estimates and you can communicate to respective stakeholders. Okay, so any other question before I make a closing? So these are my details, and you can contact me. I think most of you are already part of our LinkedIn group. If you are not, please join our LinkedIn group. It is PMIACP Agile Certification Made Easy, and we tend to try to do a good amount of interaction and discussion in our LinkedIn group. So if you are not part of it, please join, and let me know whenever you have any query related to certification or Agile. So the LinkedIn group is PMIACP Agile Certification Made Easy. So if you just search Agile Certification Made Easy, you will reach to our group. Okay, so thanks for joining in, and drop me a mail or follow-up question, whatever you have. I would be happy to answer and help you out as much I can. Thank you, friends. Thanks for joining in.